this is going to be the year. This is going to be the year that we put our safety case together, and with our platform folks, assuming that's ready, we will be deploying driverless trucks on the road in Texas.
This week on Pittsburgh's Action News 4, we are taking a look at a local company on the brink of transforming one of the biggest industries in America. Aurora Innovation, headquartered in the Strip District, has created driverless semi-trucks. They are already running autonomously in Texas, but with a safety operator behind the wheel. As you just heard, though, Aurora believes before the end of this year, it will be ready to pull those drivers, leaving the semi-trucks to drive themselves. Today, we hear from the company's chief safety officer and others in the industry to find out if America's streets are ready for this type of revolution.
Not only would it cut a lot of jobs out, but it's not going to be safe. I don't believe it would ever be a safe thing to do.
Talk to some professional drivers like we did, and they'll tell you they don't think we're ready for driverless semi-trucks.
Because you got to be able to make split-second decisions. Okay, should I hit this deer or should I hit this car?
As we learned during COVID, professional drivers are essential. If you look around the room you're in, almost everything you see has been delivered on a truck. It's also a dangerous profession. In 2022, the National Highway Transportation Safety Administration says 5,936 people were killed in wrecks involving large trucks. That is up from 3,675 in 2010. Chief Safety Officer of Pittsburgh-based Aurora Innovation, Nat Buse, says they hope the company's driverless semis reduce those deaths.
That's a huge cost to society. You know, you think of the families that are impacted by that. Loved ones that are never coming home because of that, right? We don't have to accept that.
Their tech was designed and tested here in Pittsburgh at their headquarters in the Strip District and on the Almano test track in Hazelwood. In the last story, we showed you how Aurora's proprietary LiDAR allows the trucks to see 500 yards into the distance and keep tabs on other drivers nearby in a 360-degree field of vision. Still, some professional drivers are skeptical.
If it'll ever work, there's too many people out there that don't pay attention to what they're doing. They pull in front of trucks every day, slam on the brakes. You know, a driverless semi can't predict what other people are doing.
But Aurora says it can. They gave us a demo at Almano of that exact scenario that truck driver just mentioned. Watch as this white SUV pulls right in front of the Aurora truck and slams on the brakes. Without a driver on board, the truck stops too. Another piece of Aurora's training is happening in Texas. Since 2021, a fleet of trucks has logged over 1 million miles on two interstates with a safety driver behind the wheel. CEO Chris Urmsum says the drivers have been teaching the tech how to respond.
So they'll drive a truck down the road and we'll record what they do. And we'll look at, okay, in this situation, there's a vehicle stopping in front and another pulled out around. How did they respond? And then we use machine learning to incorporate that into how the Aurora driver drives.
Here are a few more demos. Watch in this clip as a pedestrian hides from the truck and then walks out at the last moment. Again, the truck stops quickly. Sometimes trucks have to navigate debris in the roadway. In this case, I threw a garbage can in front of one of the trucks and it dodged it. The engineers even taught the trucks how to respond to police. When the truck registers the lights and sirens, it pulls off the road and offers instructions to officers written on the outside of the truck on how to unlock this box to find its documents. By nature, this tech eliminates 100% of impaired and distracted driving. But what about scenarios the engineers couldn't think of?
So the way we're managing that is through the data set that USDOT has created. So USDOT went and looked at what are the different ways that vehicles get in crashes. And they came up with these 37 scenarios, they call it. And we took those and we said, okay, what if we put the Aurora driver in each of these scenarios, but we're looking at those and we're saying, okay, even if the crash was not avoidable, did we put the brakes on early enough, or did we try to lane change at the appropriate time?
And Aurora and other companies using autonomous tech are required to report any incidents to NHTSA's standing general order. As of March 15th, Aurora has reported 5 incidents. In 3 of those cases, another vehicle hit into Aurora. In the other 2, road debris hit the windshield. Buse says they are 93% finished with their safety case.
If something were to happen in this next 7% of the work that you have left to do, even though the company has kind of, you know, put the flag down and said 2024 is going to be the year, it would be very disappointing probably to a lot of people if it wasn't. If there was something that came up that you felt should keep these from not being on the roads from a safety perspective, would you speak up about that?
Of course. And not only me, probably a lot of other people in this company, which is, again, speaks to the richness of the safety culture here. You know, very few times in your life do you get to work on something like this that's going to have such a tremendous impact. And we also understand the delicate balance of the public trust. And yeah, we are not going to put this truck on the road if we don't close that safety case.
Another fair concern that you may have watching this story is, what if the computer fails or something happens to one of the sensors?
Our solution for that is a dual computer, basically. So we have a primary computer and then we have a redundant computer. And one of the big wins that we got last year was actually having that generation of hardware that we're actually going to launch be hardened. So, you know, being able to fail over if something happens, those are all things that we've already, I don't want to say, maybe check the box makes it sound simple, but that box has been checked, that claim has been closed, and we're on our way.
As far as hacking goes,
we do have triggers in there to be able to detect that stuff.
Buse says that's part of Aurora's safety case too.
Now, safety is also the reason that Aurora is only operating in Texas right now. The weather there, obviously, more favorable for driving. But CEO Chris Urmson says that they are doing some smaller tests in snow and other inclement weather. And they say if this run in Texas is successful, they hope to expand here to Pittsburgh and in other parts of the country in the next 5 to 10 years. Now, coming up tomorrow, we're going to take a look at the impact that this would have on the trucking industry. We're going to hear from drivers and trucking unions. We'll also meet some students who are about to graduate from a robotics program that was created in partnership with Aurora to service the tech, creating some brand new jobs. We're going to have a look at the ripple effect this is having on Pittsburgh's business community as well. All of that coming up tomorrow right here on Pittsburgh's Action News 4.